In today's Axure tutorial, we are going to look at basic styling options. First, let's add some widgets to a page. When you add headings, paragraphs, or buttons, you're actually adding elements that use a CSS style. If you want to have a clean-looking prototype, there's two options that are very important. First, this icon here allows you to align elements, so let's align them in the middle. And this icon allows you to distribute elements horizontally or vertically, so that there's the same spacing in between all the elements you selected. So for example, here I have three and it will center the button in the middle, compared to the extremes. Now we have a heading here. And as you can see, it uses a heading 3 style, which is our CSS style. If we change our heading, for example, we make it red, you'll see that there's a small star which indicates that you edited this style. If you click on the update link, you'll see it will make all headings 3 look like the first one that you edited. Let's make it green now and not update. And now let's change the other one. So you see it doesn't have a star. Let's make it green. Actually, it won't be visible enough. Let's make it blue. Yeah. Now if I hit update, you see the other one remained green because it's been edited. So if you want it to actually become blue, you can use the drop down and just select heading 3 again. It will be updated and undo the changes you made to this one. Try not to make local changes unless you need to, because using the styles make sure that your prototype remains consistent. In this dropdown, you can actually change the style quite easily. For example, if you realize your heading 3 should actually be a heading 4, just click it and it will update the styles. You can also make it a heading 2 or bring it back to heading 3. This also works with rectangles and stuff. The same way, you can make a button a primary button or a regular button, switch it back to a link. CSS styles also include corner radius. You can drag and drop the little yellow arrow here to edit the corner radius. Notice that the corner radius actually changes the CSS style. And if you want to have a very precise radius, you can type the value in this field. You can edit the text alignment and add some padding so that it doesn't touch the border here. So let's add a padding of 20, for example. Next one here. So now you can see there's 20 pixels from the sides and at least 20 pixels from the bottom. So this all changes the CSS style. Let's make the borders thicker. Okay, and then update. Now there are some other changes that you can make to style this that don't affect the CSS. You'll find these in the Properties tab, under shape, and there you can select a shape. For example, let's make it look like a back button. Now you see the shape is changed. If you look at the style, the CSS has not. You can also edit the shape by using the small gray circle. If you click on it, you'll see a menu that allows you to select a different shape. Lastly, you can also make your button look like it's slanting. Either grab one of the corners, hold Command and drag and drop with your mouse, or enter the values directly in the field here. You can edit separately the rotation of the whole button and the rotation of the text. So if you want the text to look straight, but the speech bubble to be slanted, you can do it like this. Now, if you want to edit the style of your whole prototype, just go to Project and click on Widget Style Editor. This is very convenient if you already made a black and white prototype and just need to add a layer of color, or to reproduce a style guide inside Axure before actually starting to prototype. And that's it for today. Thanks for watching.